Happy New Year.
Oh, yeah, my brother. It'll be a happy New Year.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Troy, you get ready for the
weekend? Hi, Troy.
How's your bag?
They were holding my edges, dear. The deepest boots. So what did you do over the bridge, okay? Your nails or your scales? Just like all the other snakes. Moving can be such a drag. Did you do least any fun over winter break?
Oh, you know, my mom took me on a ski trip, but all I did was read.
Excellent, another bookworm.
With all those cute boys and subs, why do you think Prada makes his fabulous après ski wear? Loser!
Well, actually, I didn't mean a guy.
See? So make with the newsflash, sister, I'm all ears.
The slopes were perfect, and I met the hottest little snow bunny ever.
You'll never guess how I met him. Snowboarding?
Snowboarding.
Singing, he was pretty good too.
She was so hot, the slopes turned slow.
Yeah.
Singing. They never got into the game.
Tonight, this will be the start of something new. If you
Oh, for the very first morning announcements of the brand new year, this is Jack Scott, fellow Fog of Eastside, on what's going down and coming up this week. The signs to Castle on Finals are on Friday. See Taylor, Learning Curve, McKenzie for more skinny on the hooey. During free period, the science club will meet in room 213 and then switch midway with the AV club in room 312 for the next 2.5 sessions, then reverse and alternate the schedules for the second half of the winter quarter. The skydiving club will be meeting at 3 p.m. on the roof deck, and the first day club will be meeting from the down in the park club below. All for now, peeps.
But soft, what lied through yonder window drapes? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon, who is already sick and pale with grief. Thank you very much. Well, once again, they forgot to announce the auditions for the winter musicale Juliet and Romeo, written by our very own Kelsey Nielsen. Kelsey, stand up and take a bow. It is a delicious neo-feminist adaptation of Shakespeare's classic tragedy, with three, count them, three top numbers. By thinking outside the box, Kelsey has brilliantly swapped out a tragic ending with a happy one, where the two lovers both live and move to Albuquerque. Mr. Danforth, this is a place of learning, not a football court. Please save your bilayable potatoes for some of your own primitive aesthetic. As always, the drama club faces a dearth of male participants, so please come in and audition. I'm offering you the chance to spread your wings into bold new horizons. I'm offering you the timeless allure of the grease paint, of the magical power of the clean light. All right, I'm offering you extra credit. The dreaded cell phone symphony returns to our crucible of learning. Sharpay and Ryan Evans, your phone please, and I'll see you in detention. We have zero tolerance for use of cell phones during class, so we'll get to know each other in detention. And welcome these high, Miss Montez. Mr. Bolton, I see your phone's involved. Splendid, we'll see you in detention also.
But that's not even a possibility, Mr. Arbus. You see, Your Honor, sir, you see, we have practical practice this afternoon, and Troy is...
That's 30 minutes for you too, Mr. Danforth. Count them.
That would be tough for Chad, since he probably can't even count that high.
Taylor McKenzie, 35 minutes.
But I've never had detention in my life.
Well then, Happy New Year. This isn't my first time at the Rodeo Kiddies. Shall the carnage continue?
I'll bet you can't wait to sign up for the show.
I won't be signing up for anything here for a while. I just want to get to know the school. But if you signed up, I'd consider coming to watch the show.
That's completely impossible.
I wouldn't think impossible is even your vocab, Troy. It's so nice that you show a new classmate around. Troy is such a sweetheart, isn't he? He's the star of the basketball team, just like I'm the star of the drama club. We're perfect for each other, don't you think? Oh, look, the sign next to the musical. Oh, were you going to sign up too? I'm so sure we could find something for you. The old W nurse has lots of fun.
No, no, I was just looking at the bulletin board. What's going on, disco? Wow, last time I checked.
I missed you during vacation, Troy. So, what did you do,
You know, practice basketball, snowboarding, or basketball. Gotta go, practice now.
You're so dedicated, just like me. I hope you can watch me in the musical. Promise? Maybe it's my hair.
Hey Wildcats, it's the quest time again. And this one goes out from Vice Principal Vinny Ichikawa to the person who took the air out of his tires. Sorry folks, it seems we have another request that goes something like this. Troy Button, get your butt to basketball practice on the double, or you are grounded for a week. Later, peeps.
Remember, the chain's only as strong as its weakest link. When the going gets tough, the dough gets going! I guess you know that one. Okay, Ben, give me 10 minutes of features and let me see some hustle.
Sorry, my coach. Hey, you know that school musical thing? Pretty cool that Darks is giving extra credit just for auditioning.
LeBron James, Peter Roslick, and where does she school musical?
But, you know, like, the extra credit is good for college and all.
Do you know what's even better? A big fat basketball scholarship.
You're the team captain, Bobby. Get your head in the game for real.
Man, you gotta go.
Alright, let's kick it in. Run the shuffle drill.
Yeah. party number. Be a best shot.
So, it seems like you new Troy Bolton.
Not really, I was just asking for directions.
Troy doesn't usually interact with new students.
What's that?
It's pretty much basketball 24/7 with him. Plus, he's such a bully, always picks the smaller kids.
That's nice.
He hates math and chemistry. Don't get him started on chemistry. He hasn't opened a book since The Hungry Caterpillar. Says he didn't get it. Typical job, right?
Cool.
And he's a meat eater. Ask anyone.
Yes, Gabrielle?
I'm sorry. I think it should be 10 to the negative 18. That's all.
10 to the negative 18th? I don't think so. Oh, seems I stand corrected. I'm impressed, I'm lucky award.
Did you know Troy spent a year in juvenile hall? Something to do with cats and lawnmowers.
Be gone, you have no power here.
Oh, whatever. Well, I'm impressed, you're a genius.
Please, just an equation.
Brian, it's me.
I thought Star was took a phone today.
What? He always carries spare, in case our agent calls.
Look, our science decathlon team has a big regional match on Friday, and we've never won it before, but with you on our team, you might stand a chance.
Thanks, but I think I'll pass for now. I just want to get acclimated to the new school. And
we'll promise to think about it.
Promise, yeah.
Again? He's hanging out that Montez hag this morning, and they're both going to get the list. There's something freaky about her. Do you Google her like I asked?
Yeah, it's like she has an extra brain or something. So why would she be interested in our musical?
She's interested in Troy Barfoy. You need to plant this print out in Taylor's locker ASAP, okay?
Okay, no problem, boss. But why am I doing that?
Look, there's no harm in making certain that Gabriella is welcome to the school activities that are appropriate for her. You know, the ones that keep her far away from Troy Bolton.
It's time to kiss today goodbye and point me towards attention. So all you evildoers better get your butts to the theater immediately or face the wrath of Darvis and Mercius. This is Jack Scott, signing off.
My brave little detention menagerie. We thespians often use animals to help us build the character that we play. Be the bear, be the monkey, be the ostrich. You're all doing brilliantly. Chum, chum, chum now. Explore. Wait, Ryan. Do you want to be an ostrich?
Totally.
Ryan. For Sharpay, maybe, but what about you?
Me?
Yes, unless you want to live the rest of your life in the shadow of your sister's ostrich.
The answer is yes. Oh, I'm so happy I changed my mind about the science decathlon. With credentials like these, we'll win it for sure.
Where did those come from?
Didn't you slip them in my locker?
Of course not.
Well, we'd love to have you on the team, and we meet almost every day after school. Please,
I have to get
a generous offer, Taylor. We've never ever won the science decathlon before, but you can be our answer prayer.
Okay, I guess I can. So, like a quick question. What do you know about Trouble?
Well, I wouldn't consider myself an expert on that particular subspecies unless you speak cheerleader, as it isn't Trouble just like the high super bomb.
I don't think cheerleader, I guess.
Which is why we exist in an alternate universe to Troy the basketball boy.
Have you even tried getting
him? My sis flick and I have nine. Watch it works in the school cafeteria. You'll see.
I mean, you don't think being in the musical would be fun, like, even a little?
Then who's to? I'm a musical singer person.
I'm not talking about me. I'm like,
can't expect us to focus on big game. Well, you're here to see the leotards.
No, is it anything about leotards?
I'll get my friend.
Wow, James, I myself had no idea an earthworm like yourself could have such depth, such pain. Now,
Thank you.
truly brilliant. You've given me hope for the future of the American theatre, you truly have. Now, for the lead roles of Juliet and Romeo, we have only one pair signed up, is that right? Oh well, Shark, Beret, and Ryan, show us your stuff.
Joaquin?
Hey, thanks, but we had a rehearsal penis to arrange.
Actually, I'm gonna sing third.
Yes, well, I treat these shows just as serious as your father treats his basketball practice. I called the Julian Ruby auditions and you did not respond. And we have run out of time and you're out of luck, Jack. I'm sorry.
Sure. You wrote that song around your pages then?
Uh-huh.
And the entire show?
Uh-huh.
How long did that take?
About 2 years. I wake up at 5 every morning before school and I'm still working on the finale.
Wow, that's amazing. You're so dedicated. So why are you so afraid of Sharpay anyway? It's your show.
It is? Of course it is.
Oh, isn't the author of musical like the playmaker of basketball?
The playmaker?
Like the one that makes everyone look else look good. Without you, Kelsey, there is no show. You're the playmaker here.
I am? Do you want to hear the way the song is supposed to sound?
It's just dancing, and if I'm being honest, shallow! Jacket and
to Troy Bolton's callback on school musical. One scary dude was even seen mixing into the school band string section. The humanity! The humanity.
Wow. Pretty wild, huh?
Pretty crazy meeting up like this.
This is much better, right?
Much better. So this is your final headache.
Nice on the hoarder for people. My buddies don't even know about it.
Looks to me like everyone has wants to be a friend.
Yeah. That's blue.
Your race?
My parents' friends are always saying, your son is the basketball coach. You must be so proud. Sometimes I don't want to be the basketball coach. I just want to be, you know, me.
You shouldn't be.
Right. Totally well.
At one of the schools, I was the freaky math girl.
That's all they said I was. Always pointing at me, laughing behind my back. They treated me like a freak, and I hated it. That's why I wanted to keep low profile here, you know?
But you can't let people stop you from doing what you want to do. I mean, you are what you do, right? Kinda.
That's easy for you to say. You're the big basketball star, looking in the spotlight. I want to have your career up with a couple.
Heidi?
No.
Maybe.
Well, maybe, I don't know. Remember in kindergarten where you meet a kid and 10 seconds later you'd be best friends and didn't have anything to do but yourself?
Yeah.
Singing with you like, felt like that. Like safe, you know?
I never thought about singing that. But when I look at you, it's like anything's possible, you know?
Troy's in your show.
Troy Bolton is not in my show.
Oh, well, did you like the creme brulee I made for you?
No, it doesn't go up my skirt.
That's fine. So I was wondering if you'd like to come and watch me play ball someday.
I'd rather listen to Mr. Mackey's Christmas jokes.
Troy and Gabrielle have themselves.
So what you're saying is the individual must be sacrificed for the good of the whole. That's very calm, Mark. Works for me.
We'll grab Troy in the locker room. You guys have Gabrielle in the lab at exactly 1600 hours.
Whatever, Chad, just work until you...
Troy Bolton is my best friend. I know how to push his buttons. Remember. Communication is crucial to the successful deployment of this covert operation.
I'm impressed. I didn't know you could say that many syllables in one sentence.
Thanks. I'm working on it all night. Now, what's the 1600 hours around standard time? Are we synchronized?
Save it for Charlie's Angels, Chad. Au revoir, mon ami.
Hello, will you speak German?
Something isn't right. The jocks and the brainiacs mingling in study hall.
The jocks rule most of the school, but if they get Troy in the musical, then they conquer the entire student body.
And if the brainiacs get Gabriella hooked up with Troy Bolton, the science club goes from drool to cool. Brian, we need to save our show for people who don't know the difference between a Tony Award and Tony Soprano.
How?
Darvis, I have a plan.
Lucy!
I'll tell Darvis that Troy and his dad want to sabotage the auditions because she gave him detention.
Oh, she'll never believe that.
She'll believe anything I tell her because I'm the president of the drama club.
Yeah, but the president's not supposed to lie, Sharpay.
Yeah, and the vice president's supposed to smile. Zip it and do what I tell you to do. Come on.
Hey, you don't need my help to do that.
And you, mister, I'm soaring, I'm flying.
Hi, Stars.
I thought you were genuine, Troy. Mom, can I guess?
What was that all about?
You want to tell me something, Bolton? Something about singing?
No. I mean, you know.
No, I don't know. Darth the Range just chewed my head off because she thinks you're plotting something.
Oh, I was just helping someone audition.
It's nothing. You bet it's nothing. In case you've forgotten, you have the biggest game of your life coming up in 2 days. You get your head in the game for real, Bolton. Your team is counting on you.
I was going to stay and work my free throws.
Since you're late for practice again, that's the least you can do.
Wow, so this is your real stage?
Yeah, I guess you could call it that. Or just a smelly gym.
You know, I once scored 41 points in the championship league.
No way.
Yep, the same day as I invented the iPod and PlayStation. I've been rehearsing with Kelsey.
I know, me too. And I was late for practice again, so if I get kicked off the team, it'll be on your conscience.
Hey,
carry on. Just.
Sorry, miss, this is closed practice.
The practice is over.
Not until the last player leaves the gym, Bolton. Team rules.
Sorry.
Dad, this is Gabriella Montes.
You're in attention, buddy?
Psst, Gabriella, tell me to the lab right away. Hip hop array!
I'll see you later, Troy. Nice to meet you,
good Bolton.
Goodbye. Detention is my fault, not hers.
You haven't missed practice in 3 years. This girl turns up and you're late twice.
She's not a problem, she's just a girl.
You're not just a guy, you're the team captain. What you do not only affects the team, but the whole school. Get your head in the game for real, Bolton. Your team is depending on you.
A lot of things are special, though.
So this chance you regret the rest of your life.
You mean like you?
You're a playmaker, Bolton, not a singer.
Well, did you ever think maybe I could be both? My name is Troy, Dad, not Bolton.
Wildcat Legends won league championships by worrying about some brainiac chip auditioning for musicals.
Do you think these paradigms of education and accomplishment concern themselves with jocks or auditioning for musicals?
I don't think so!
Good for him, Troy. Getting the championship he always dreamed of.
Heartbreak Bolton. Another lost cause bonehead basketballist Marana's jock. But you, you're the future of civilization.
Thank you.
Somebody in this room wanted you that sister.
And it ain't me.
We'll get the roles we want. We always do.
I'm not just talking about my role in the play, Ryan. I'm talking about my role in, like, the school. I'm not a jock. I'm not a brainiac. But you know what I am? I'm a star. That's my role. And if they take that away from me, who am I?
Well, you could just be Sharpay. That's not so bad, is it?
Are you brain dead? No one's gonna like me if I'm just Sharpay. But on stage, I can be anyone I want to be. I just don't know Sharpay. I mean, come on, they named me after a flabby dog.
Sharpay, we've been in needs every year since birth. If we get it again, great. If not, we're still fabulous. Besides, it could have been worse. We could have called you Pope or Shih Tzu or...
Troy and that... ugh, that thing.
Look, maybe Troy would like it even more if you're just yourself for once.
Pardon me, Dr. Phil, but what do you know? You're just a kid.
I'm only 8 minutes younger than you.
Yeah, well, those are 8 important minutes.
Oh. Sorry, I didn't know you were here.
Hi, Troy. Did you come to ask if I'd switch partners and audition with you? The answer is yes. Brian, you're fired.
Sharpay!
No. Have you seen Gabriella? I really have to talk to her.
Who?
Yeah.
Hey. Last time I saw her, she was in the theater, like, about 10 minutes ago. Thanks, Ryan.
You're all right.
I stabbed you back.
Well, he's doing mixed wit. I take it from the top. I lose those jazz squares.
Gabriella, you have to listen to me. What you heard yesterday, none of that's true. I didn't mean any of it.
You sounded pretty convincing to me.
Then you didn't hear the whole thing. I was sick of my friends bribing me about sitting with you, so I said things I knew would shut them up. The guy you met on vacation is way more me than the guy that said those stupid things.
But what about your dad?
This isn't about my dad. This is about me. About how I feel. And I'm not letting the team down. They let me down. I'm going to sing. What about you?
I'm not trying.
It feels so right to be here with you. Now looking in your eyes, I feel in my heart the start of something.
talk to our friends.
Well, let's move it already. We're burning daylight.
Hey, all you crazy wildcats. Just a reminder that science decathlon and basketball championship game will both start tomorrow afternoon at 3 p.m. So don't be late, baby. Come on out and support your teams in the biggest game of the year. But wait, it looks like we have a late-breaking wildcat newsflash. The callbacks for Juliet and Romeo have been moved up to tomorrow at 3 p.m. Hey, but wait, Miss Darvis, you can't. That's the same time as... Sorry, Troy. It's Jack Scott. Over now.
What? How can they do this? It's not fair!
How can you be in the science decathlon?
And win the championship.
And audition for my show.
We can't.
Well, it's clear now you have no choice.
There's only one thing you can do.
Yeah, I know.
Maybe next year, right?
Audition for the musical.
What? But what about the team?
I thought you wanted to do decathlon.
So we come in second. That's no disgrace.
Win or lose, we're a teammate. That's what we're about. He's going to try to be the worst singer in the world.
He's fantastic. They both are.
We feel so wrong for what we did, and we want you both to know that we'll be cheering, in spirit anyway.
Yeah, Kat. If singing is something you want to do, we should be boosting you up, not tearing you down.
If that I couldn't see, you were always there beside me. Good luck in the big game, Troy. Sorry, I had to call about Gabriella.
Yeah, so anyway, we made our decision.
I'll be different team player.
Me too, guys. It's just a musical, man.
Just a musical!
You know what he means. Our friends are depending on us. We can't let them down.
But you can't.
But we can. See you guys later. Come on, Gary.
We can't let them do this.
Yeah, it changed fair and all that.
We have to figure out a way for them to do both.
Team huddle.
Hey, it's no joke.
I'm good at foreign languages, remember?
Thanks for the second.
Jack Scott can help us. He's a nice big game.
It's impossible.
Listen to me. I can do anything on my own.
Yesterday.
Something should
guys. The following events are all starting immediately. Besides the Castellon is in the second floor lab. The auditions for Juliet and Romeo are in the theatre, and the league basketball championship game is in the gym. Wildcats rule, baby!
Where were you?
Please, just one more time.
Rules are rules, Miss Montez.
Please, just give us a chance to start.
A chance for what, Troy? To make a joke out of something that means everything to me and your fellow classmates who actually came to audition?
It was not a joke. I came to give it my best shot.
There's only a few more minutes until the lights come back on.
I'm sorry, but no.
As president of the drama club, I have to put my foot down. No special treatment. Those are your words, not mine.
Miss Darvis, Troy wasn't trying to screw up the auditions. Charmaine lied to you because she was afraid of losing the part.
Shut up!
Is that true? Did you abuse the presidential privilege and knowingly lie to me?
I didn't lie. I improvised a little.
We'll talk about this later, Miss Evans, but right now, off the stage. Off the stage. Troy.
Darvis?
Troy, Gabriella, you may begin your callback.
But we don't have a penis.
We'll sing without music.
Oh, no, you won't. Pianist here, Miss Darvis.
You really don't want to do that?
Oh, yes, I really do. Ready on stage?
No, that's showbiz.
Soaring, flying, there's not a star. Heaven that we can't reach.
If we try it, so we'd break the tree.
No, the world would see us in a way that's different from who we are.
In space between us, in the circle.
But your faith in gives me strength. See?
almost forgot the words.
I mean your foul shots. Brilliant. Your son can sure shoot the hoops.
He's not a bad singer either.
I wonder where he gets it from.
Soaring.
No, seriously, where does he get it from?
We want to.
Like on a date.
Must be a lucky day.
Warriors. Just like anything, right?
Only bad.
I really love your voice.
All's well that ends well, right?
Yeah, I guess I'll just play the nurse. That is, unless you can't go on, so break a leg.
In theory, that's a good girl.
Don't mention it to anyone, ever.
Sorry, you didn't get the pie chart, Peyton.
Join the club.
I still think you're fabulous, though.
Really? You do?
Really, really. Come on.
Just like you do, guys.
I'll be back.